This is the true story of one tech-addicted journalist who moved into a motorhome for 24 hours to find out, through a series of challenges, that 5G could power all of her home devices at once.
All right. Come on in. Back here, we've got my living room, bedroom, and so many gadgets.
All right, so this isn't really a reality TV show. Now, let's talk about what's happening here in this 5G RV, trademark pending. See that pole? That's a Verizon 5G small cell. And inside the RV is a Verizon OnePlus 8 5G smartphone. It's getting crazy fast speeds from the tower. 10 times faster than my home Wi-Fi, in fact. Also inside the RV, 15 other gadgets that are being powered by 5G via the phone's hotspot feature. Yes, all of those are getting 5G connectivity. So why the heck did I do this? Well, see, I live here in Jersey City, which is just being lit up with 5G service from all the major US carriers. But the fastest type of 5G, called millimeter wave, requires that you be within a few hundred feet from the cell site to get top speeds. And you guessed it, my real home? Not next to a pole yet.
Yes, the speeds are insanely fast, but on a smartphone, they're not really that helpful. I mean, how often do you need to download 5 movies in 5 minutes? Where I really need these speeds are at home, where I have multiple connected devices and multiple family members using them.
So that's what I'm trying to test in here, in a series of daunting home bandwidth challenges.
This is a wall?
But within a movable home.
And this in here is the bathroom with full 5G service. But before the challenges, you have to understand the complicated world of 5G. Buckle up.
There are two types of 5G in the US at the moment. Millimeter wave 5G, named for its high frequency waveforms, is insanely fast, at least 6 times faster than 4G in my tests, and 10 times faster than my home Wi-Fi. But the coverage is very limited. You need to be within a few hundred feet or so of a cell site to get the signal and the speed. It doesn't penetrate walls or other obstacles very well. Verizon, AT&T, and T-Mobile are putting up millimeter wave cells throughout the country. By this one, I got 1,300 megabits per second download speeds on Verizon's network. On my home Wi-Fi, I get 100 megabits per second. That 5G speed is bonkers. Then there's sub-6, named for a set of frequencies below 6 gigahertz. It's not as fast as millimeter wave, but it was faster than 4G LTE in my tests. And it's more practical because it works inside buildings and the coverage is more widespread. For now, only AT&T and T-Mobile have sub-6, including here in Jersey City. Verizon says it plans to roll out its sub-6 network before the end of the year in the US. In downtown Jersey City, AT&T's sub-6 coverage averaged 80 to 90 megabits per second, and T-Mobile's sub-6 got 120 megabits per second. Still pretty good, at least when I could find strong 5G signal strength. Regardless of carrier, you need a new 5G phone to get these speeds. Okay, on to the challenges. Challenge 1, video streaming. To simulate my home, I fired up Frozen 2 on the TV, 2 4K video streams on these laptops, a FaceTime call to my mom.
I have no makeup on whatsoever.
You look great.
And of course, for security, I installed a connected doorbell. On all 3 networks, the streams were good, and the video call was clear. To really up the 5G stakes, I added in a call to my dad and placed another video call to my colleagues.
How do I look now?
No, you look very clear.
This test was hit or miss. It was hard to tell what issues were caused by the network or the phone's hotspots.
Where are you at? I can't see you.
You can't see me?
These really aren't meant to connect 10 devices at a time. Plus, some of the carrier's plans have data caps on hotspot usage and slow down speeds once you exceed it. Challenge 2, gaming. I don't know a ton about gaming.
Oh, yeah, boom. Is that good?
That's your teammate.
No, I gotta punch her.
So I made my producer, Kenny, a world-renowned gamer, just kidding, he only plays on the weekends, jump in and start playing Apex Legends, first on Verizon's millimeter wave network. I know, I'm a horrible boss.
Listen, I was impressed. The game played better than it did on my wired home broadband connection by a long shot. There's no rubber banding where you lag warp from one place to another and no lag icons. finally, we can game in the bush.
I was similarly impressed with the graphics and speed on the Oculus Quest VR headset. Menus loaded super fast, large games downloaded within minutes, and I attended a live in-person VR event, even while Kenny was playing on the Xbox on the same network. Verizon's network held strong. T-Mobile's 5G performed similarly, but AT&T's was shaky.
Don't blame the internet.
And Kenny complained the game was laggy, even when we tried to move to a better location. Challenge 3, uploading. Uploading a 1 GB folder to Google Drive took 6 to 7 minutes on each 5G network. On my home Wi-Fi, it took 4.5 minutes. The most I was able to notch was about 60 megabits on the upload on Verizon. My home network has 100 megabits per second on upload speeds.
So what did we learn here today? We learned that 5G is very, very fast and a lot more useful when you can connect multiple gadgets to that network than just, say, a single phone.
Of course, this isn't the intended use of 5G yet, and it will take time for the carriers to improve coverage and release home routers and hotspots for this type of use. Verizon already has a 5G home offering in some markets, and T-Mobile is gearing up to do the same. Of course, you'll probably end up paying more for it all too. But for now, if I owned an RV, I'd plot out my family vacations one 5G pole at a time.
Okay, this was fun, but I miss my family, and I would like to go home.